Some people would consider Eric Koston like the Michael Jordan of skateboarding. So if Koston's Michael Jordan, I think P-Rod would be considered like the Kobe Bryant. And I really like that comparison because I feel like P-Rod was the first one to take that super methodical approach like Kobe Bryant and apply it to skateboarding. When you listen to Paul Rodriguez talk about skateboarding, it's really apparent that there is no accident why he became so good at skateboarding. And in this video, I want to focus on one practice technique that P-Rod mentioned to Deshaun Jordan and Deshaun Jordan mentioned on the 9 Club. And then we're gonna head to the skate park and we're gonna test out this technique to see how it can impact our skating. Roll the clip.
I feel like how I learned my tricks, like, you know, recently or just like the past couple years of skating, I remember I was skating with Paul one day at the barracks and he says something like, it was like, you don't really have a trick until you can pop in and pop out where you want to. Okay. And so after that, like, I would go to the park and I would try to, every trick that I had, slide or grind, I would start at the beginning of the ledge and just try to hold them.
Gotcha.
And so, like, I mean, even on the flat bar, like, I do every trick from the beginning of the flat bar. Like, okay. I don't, like, I just try to, like, you know, learn how to hold them and be able to, like, you know, do stuff out of them. And so after that, I feel like that's kind of how it unlocked that, like, way of like learning how to like hold slides and stuff, and that's why it felt more like possible to me to like try it, you know.
Isn't it funny? Just like one little comment from somebody can like change your whole outlook on how you do that shit.
Especially P-Rod.
I know. Yeah.
I feel like this is a common theme with a lot of the really good skaters today, is they just set such high standards for themselves, like higher than anybody else. If somebody can crooked grind, P-Rod wants to be able to kickflip crooked grind or kickflip out of a crooked grind or find like the smallest detail about crooked grind and like master it, be able to do it any way that he wants to. It's not good enough just to do the trick. You need to be able to understand the trick and control the trick. So in today's session, I'm gonna skate a lot of ledges and I'm gonna see how many tricks I can get in early and pop out in the middle, as well as get in the middle and then pop out at the end. And then number three, hold the full length of the ledge. So ultimately my goal is to be able to crooked grind the ledge from beginning to end. That's like what I'm working towards. So let's go get into the session, practice some ledge tricks like P-Rod, and then I'll check back in with you when it's all over and let you know my thoughts of practicing this way.
Man, that is two exhausting sessions in a row. Luckily, I literally just beat the rain. If you can see, it's starting to sprinkle on the windshield, so. Man, I feel like I really, really pushed myself to do what Paul Rodriguez said. Unfortunately, like, I'm not too great at skating ledges, so I only did like 4 tricks, right? I think I did front 50, back 50, no slide, and crook. But just doing those 4 tricks, but having to control where you pop in and pop out, like, that was exhausting. For me, I feel really, really comfortable skating the second half of the ledge. But getting in early and popping out was scary, and obviously getting in early and doing the entire thing was really, really terrifying. Definitely not so much for like the front 50s, but the back 50s was a little bit scary. The nose slide was a mission, and so was the crook. Honestly, I think the crook would have been easier than the nose slide, except for I had just expended so much energy trying to get the nose slide, like my legs were dying. And then I had to really, really fight to get that crook on the red ledge over the mani pad. Hopefully you guys aren't getting bored with like all these bails, but like that's the reality of it. Like I had to fight for these tricks today. I'm kind of bummed the crook on the mani pad or on the red ledge, I came to like a dead stop and then just like forced myself to stay over the board. So I came out to fakie, which I think doesn't really count unless you like really pop out to fakie, because it's kind of like a cop out because your board just kind of like falls out in that direction anyway. So unless you like really pop it, I think crook to fakies are pretty budget. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Are crook to fakies budget or buttery? Anyways, I hyped I even got it. Like, I don't know. I guess like part of me doesn't even count it, but part of me is still hyped that I even like got over the manual pad into the other side and stayed on my board. So I'll appreciate it for what it is, but I definitely want to get another one. I just need to get used to going faster at that ledge so that I can get to the end and have speed to be able to pop out to forward. Man, but yesterday's session, I like went really, really hard, and I feel like today I went equally as hard. I didn't skate for as long today. Normally I skate for like 3 hours. Today I skated only for 2. So I was really, really trying to pack in as many tricks in the beginning as I could. That's why I didn't like move my tripod. I was just like firing off as many tricks as I could on the hip and then doing some on the ledge as well, on the baby ledges. I tried to make sure I have like at least 30 to 40 tricks in each video, but it can be really hard when I'm doing videos like this where I'm trying things that are beyond my skill level. And like I said, I'm sorry if there was like a lot of bails in there. Some of you guys want to see the bails. Some of you guys probably don't want to see the bails. Let me know if I'm putting too many bails in there, but I'm trying to like make it a healthy balance that you get kind of an understanding of what it takes to actually do what I'm doing at the skill level that I'm at, while also not boring you guys to tears, because this stuff, like these videos take me like so long and you see like a minute or 2 minute edit. But yeah, overall consensus, I definitely think that this is a smart way to practice. Not just like this specific technique of making sure that you can pop out early or come in late or just do the whole ledge. Like that's just one concept among many where basically you're just trying to find nuances of a trick that you can already do and try and push it to like the next level. Like if you can 180, can you like bone out your 180s? Can you like late nose manual pivot your 180s? Like do you have total control to do a particular trick any way that you want to? So just kind of like looking for the gaps in your board control and taking the time to really understand how to make your board do what you want it to. Practicing like with that mindset doesn't just benefit you with the trick that you're trying. That's gonna start building into other tricks that you're trying to learn because you've taken the time to actually understand your board. So then when you're trying a trick that you've never done before, you just use the building blocks that are already there and just kind of put them together in a different way than you ever have before. But if you really understand how to control your board, most tricks are essentially kind of the same thing, if that makes sense. Anyways, super hyped on the video. Shout out to the GOAT, P-Rod, Paul Rodriguez. If there's anybody that's like my idol or like inspiration, not just in skateboarding, but like as a person overall, I would have to say it's Paul Rodriguez. Just like his work ethic and confidence and humility, just I feel like he is like the total package, just in a lot of ways, kind of a blueprint for how I want to live my life. So shout out to you,
P-Rod, if you do ever watch this, doubt it, but you probably won't, but I hope that God and the universe compensate you for all like the positivity and inspiration that you are to so many of us, even people that don't even know you. All right, guys, that's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Remember to make every single day a Friday. Don't sell yourself short. Figure out what you have to offer in this world, something that you love and something that the world needs, and figure out how to make that the center of your life. That's what Friday is all about. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.